everybody, and welcome back to the Excessive Gaming Channel and Farm Simulator 2017. This is our Let's Play series here on the West Coast, and today we are up to episode number 12. So if you could quickly drop us a like, it would be much appreciated. And of course, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well. So what are we doing today? Well, today we are going to be, let's jump into the Valtra N series. Got the front loader on. Today what we're going to be doing is some baling. We've got the front loader on there, but we've got no tools on. We're going to connect up to the New Holland round belt baler. This is the 150, and yeah, we're taking it up to the field that we previously we cut the grass and got it all windrowed together, tedded it and windrowed it together. So we'll just cut through the field around the outside so we're not damaging too much of the grass, and just squeeze through there. Oh, typical, we hit the post there. Look, back that up and try again. So yeah, and this is the field that we got all done. So what we're going to do is just line up. Of course we can line up. How driving this week's been atrocious, but yeah, get that unfolded, lower the pickup down and turn it on, and off we go. As we've seen this many a times before, it's just up and down the field collecting the grass up, of course, or in this case the hay. Oh, missed a bit there. So like we say, pretty straightforward, up and down the field. Any of it we miss, we can always pick up afterwards. But how many bales do you think we're going to get from this field? Let us know in the comment section. That's one there, so unload that. But yeah, how many bales do you think we are going to get off this field? Let us know in the comment section down below. Shouldn't get too many off this field. It's relatively small field. That's another one. Load that there. Hopefully it don't roll away. No, that's fine. Close it back up. We can carry on. Might as well run round the outer edge now. Missed another bit there. Missed some more there. There we go. So we'll just back that one into the field a bit so it's not in the hedge when we unload. Let's see if we can reverse it properly. There we go. Unload it there. Once again, hopefully it won't roll away. That's fine. So we'll carry on. There's bits and pieces we've missed around the field, but never mind. So have we got enough to finish off a complete bale? Not quite. Let's pick up these odds and ends that we keep missing. Blimey. Yeah, our reversing is atrocious at the moment. Collect those few odd bits up. There's a bit there. There's a couple of odd bits just up here. We're not quite there for that full bow. It's there. another bit there. And I believe that is going to be it. So, yeah, not quite enough in there for that one. But never mind. So we can turn that off, lift the pickup up, fold it all the way. And yeah, I think what we'll quickly do, let's just grab a quick screenshot for today. There we go. So what we'll do is take this back into the farm. We're leaving what hay we've got in there, as we'll soon be doing the field again. A couple of pallets of wool there. Get those picked up relatively soon. So we'll put the baler away back in the shed, drop that there. We'll head on round. What we're going to do is we need to pick up the... I have to move that bucket out of the way. Pop that there for a second. And of course we want to pick up that bale spike, hopefully without knocking over the New Holland's Arms front loader. So yeah, what we're going to do is just go head round, pick up those couple of bales. So we've only got three bales in the field. Head on round. And yeah, what we're going to do is attempt to pick up all three bales. Get lined up with this one. Hopefully the tractor's got enough weight in it to counterbalance all three bales. So back ourselves up, we'll get it in line. Perhaps didn't need to back up that much, but never mind. So put that next to that one, hopefully without knocking it as well. Get them both as close as possible. And in line, drop that there. There we go. Nice and steady, there we go, they've stayed together. Nothing worse than them rolling away. So we'll grab the third one. What we're going to do is balance that on the top of the two bales. And like I say, hopefully the tractor will be able to lift all three bales in together. Get ourselves lined up. Push those tines into the bale. Lift that one up. And hopefully, like I say, they're going to go together without without rolling down the hill. Here we go. Nice and steady. Yeah, we're in line there, just about. Not the straightest, but we'll drop that there. And yeah, they've stayed together. So, I'll lower down for the get the tines just in bottom two bales. Nice and steady. And we can lift those up all together. Whoa. Oh, it's tipped. Typical. It's balanced, but it has tipped, so we need to be very careful here. Otherwise, of course, they are going to go flying off. Nice and steady. So we could take that steady there, put the beacons on, as we are a serious hazard here. Oh, it's going to hit the floor as we go into that little dip. Yeah, we'll just squeeze through the gate there. We clear this side. Yep. Nice and steady. Well, no, it's going. Oh, it's gone. And it rolls down towards the wall, and it stopped at the wall there. Typical. So we're going to drop these down here in the field, get ourselves lined up, and hopefully get it put back on. nice and steady without them rolling away. Once again, get ourselves lined up. Lift that one up there. And hopefully get ourselves lined up just here. Nice and steady, of course. Down. Is it going to roll? No, it's fine there at the moment. Just want to get ourselves across and lined up square with it, otherwise we'll have the same problem. Gently lift that up, try not to tilt back too far this time. Steady. So nice and steady off the ground there. No, it's going to roll. I'll take this extremely slowly. So what I was about to say was in theory we are saving time by doing this. Lowering itself down again, weight pulling it down. Are we going uphill or is that lifting that back wheel off the ground? We're going uphill, getting nice and steady, winding the gatepost. Very steadily. Oh, it's coming off the tines, look. No, we tilted it back too far. Still pushing it off. Oh, that's that one gone again. Oh no, and another one. It's all going wrong. It's all going wrong. Push that one through. Dear, oh dear. It's a disaster. Oh no. Now we've just hit the IBC as well. Yeah, it's all going horribly wrong. It's been an absolute atrocious start to today's episode. Yeah, absolutely terrible. We'll chuck that one in there then. Head on back out. I'll have to start going picking them up. Yeah, it's a disaster. So we'll chuck that one in the shed as well. Drop that one down there. Yeah, that's it. Literally chuck it in the shed. So we'll go and grab that other bale out of the field. Literally just quickly hook it on. Again, that one could be chucked in the shed. Hopefully get off. Nope. Let's try again, put it down. Nope. There we go, it's off now. Yeah, it's been one of those weeks so far. Every episode we've recorded, we've hit something. Well, let's push this IBC back. It is one of the decoration pallets. It's not actually a pallet we're using. It's been added in as part of the map creator's choices. Let's just push it back over there. There we go. So that is that bit done. What we're going to do next is move these pallets of wool out of the way. So we'll put this bowel spikes back. We'll pick up the pallet forks. And there we go. Hopefully we can get in there without too much bother. And then all we're going to do is just slide these pallets in under the shelter here. Like I say, we've got two full pallets there, 2,000 litres of wool on each pallet. Let's get those spikes a bit lower, the tines a bit lower. Push in there we go. So like I say, all we're going to do is just drop them in the shed here for the time being. Drop it down, not quite on there, back a bit, there we go. Drop that down now. There we go, that's one. Yeah, 2,000 litres of wool on each pallet, so that's 4,000 litres we've got. I'll have a little look at the price in just a moment. Get that tines in there once again. Up there we go. Drop it down there. Come on, you coming off? No, come on off. You're a bit just stuck now. There we go, we got it off. One way or another, it's coming off. So, there we go. Let's have a quick look at the prices menu. Wherever it is. There it is. So, yeah, look, the price of wool, we've got 14,800. And that's per 1,000 litres. So, I've pretty good price, but we will of course wait until we've got some more pallets in, so we should make ourselves some very, very good money there. So we'll get this put away, pop that back in the shed there, drop that down, lights off, engine off, etc. So that's the Valtra done with. So what we're going to do next is get this gate closed up, finished in the field there. In fact, we're not going to close gate up because we'll be back in there anytime soon. But yeah, let's jump into the Lizard Pickup TT, see if we can have a good drive with this one now. And what we're going to do is head on up to Hill Ridge Farm. Make a start on some seeding, I think. So turn right here. See how good the driving is on the way back. The reason our driving is so bad at the moment is because we've been playing State of Decay 2. That, of course, somewhat different to the driving of this vehicle. Just on the right here, we've got the Wednesday stores. This is where we sell the wool that we were just talking about. Just drop it into the little yellow box there. And yeah, get the money rolling in. So we'll head on back to Hill Ridge Farm, like I say. What we're going to do is pick up the Massey Ferguson and make a start on some planting today. Up the hill. Yeah, all over the place with our terrible driving. This is Hill Ridge Farm on the left here. Did we leave the gate open? I believe we did. Yeah, there we go. So we'll just park up in there. Shut the engine off, jump out. And yeah, into the Massey Ferguson 7726. And we can go and pick up the Verdistad Cedar. Blimey, what are we doing? Yeah, what are we doing indeed? Blimey. Driving is atrocious today. So we'll pick up the Verdistan seeder. I think we've got enough seed in there. Calendar shows that we're pretty much in season for planting everything. All the crops are ready to be planted. But what we're going to do is plant up the soybeans. Get the bit changed over there to the correct seed. And I mean, as all the gates are open, we might as well come straight through here onto field number 10, I believe it is. So we'll get lined up this edge. And we'll attempt to get lined up. But with our terrible reversing skills, it ain't happening today. There we go. So, we don't need to worry about cultivating the ground over, as this is a built-in cultivator and seeder together. Of course, breaks the soil down and then puts the seed in. We are just cutting the field completely in half. Not quite half, but get the idea. Over the pathway. And of course, we can stop just before the hedge, unlike the worker, of course. Lift it up, turn it off, turn around. Get ourselves lined up again, and of course lower down and turn it back on once again, and off we go. So yeah, it's a relatively straightforward job. Field. And of course we can finish off the headlands afterwards. Turn it around, get ourselves lined up once more. Through the hedge, lower it down, turn it on, and off we go once again. Nice straightforward job. Not that we can get the straight lines. Of course, by us doing it, we are saving the money that we would be spending on a worker, of course. So what we're going to do here is just turn it round and leave a gap. Now, what we're doing by doing it this way, it means that we can, of course, keep the seeder moving, keep it switched on and keep it moving without too much time wasted. It's a relatively quick, or I say quicker, way to plant the field up. But everybody has their own opinions, of course. So we'll do the same here. We've of course got that gate to avoid. To the end, turn it round and leave that gap once again. So yeah, we find it a quicker way of doing the field like this. We tend to do it when we do the contracting jobs. It appears it's a quicker way of getting the field done so you get that extra time bonus, of course. And then, of course, you go back to fill in the blanks afterwards. So it's a way of keeping the cedar moving, and effectively it speeds up the process. So we'll turn here, turn back to the left, and we can start going over the gaps, filling in. And the thing of doing it this way, it means that you tend to get, like I say, the fill done quicker. Of course, filling in the blanks, it makes it feel like you've done the job a lot faster as well. Well, I'd say that's my own opinion. Let us know your thoughts. Do you have a faster way of doing things? Again, let us know in the comment section down below. Always enjoy your feedback. Of course, we're going to miss a few bits on the ends, but we can get them with the headlands afterwards. So yeah, we was going to just do the sheep today. Not sheep, the baling. Get our words right. Yeah, of course, it doesn't take particularly long, just those few bales that we sorted out. So, yeah, we thought we'd best do some more planting, or do some planting, shall we say. We'll turn right here, and then head back up, do the full row once again. And then, of course, we can start snaking once again. Like I say, we find it as quite a good little job to do. I think it gets the fields done quicker. So there's the worker messing about. We've got that gate coming up once again. Look, still not closed it. We'll turn a little bit sooner. Hit it, of course. Okay, that's it. So once again, we'll leave that gap, and then of course we can fill in afterwards. Field. Like I say, by doing the snaking, it keeps the cedar moving. So like I say, you soon filling in the blanks, and you pretty much finish the field. Like I say, we first started doing this technique when we was doing contracting, when we first started playing Farm Simulator. I'd say first playing Farm Simulator, when we first started playing the 2017 game. Contracting was on there, and of course there was that thing about getting the field done as quickly as you can to get that extra time bonus. Yeah, we started doing this method, and we noticed that the progression bar, the pie chart type of thing, was filling up really, really quickly. And it was getting a huge time bonus. short time. Soon getting done over that pathway and that. Ground tends to blend in with the pathway, of course. But once the field starts growing, it'll soon disappear. I say disappear, but be a bit more obvious, in fact, where the actual pathway is, because you'll see the crops, splitting the crops, of course. Like I say, we're planting soybeans up here. It's one of the more expensive crops, so if you can get a good yield off these, it is very good indeed. But as you can see, the field is getting done pretty quickly now. We'll certainly get in there. Just run the edge of the field. And I think we can start filling in some of the banks, of course. Just not quite wide enough there to do all of that, not to worry. So like I say, we'll start filling in the blanks, and then of course the field will be nearly finished. We've just got that other big bit on the right of the field to get done and finished. Yeah, the field is certainly coming together now. So I think we best start bringing this episode to a close. We are, of course, well into the time. We've recorded for a fair amount of time now. So yeah, I think what we're going to do is actually end the episode very shortly. We are going to get the field finished off ourselves. Just come down this edge here and get those few bits that we missed where it's just not quite wide enough. And then, so we can get finished off. Around there. So, like I say, we are going to get the rest of this field finished off. If you have enjoyed today's episode, remember to drop us a like on today's video. It would be much appreciated, of course. If for any reason you need to hit that dislike button, please drop in the comments why you've disliked today's video so we can sort it out again in the next episode, of course. Don't like to disappoint anybody. But if, of course, you are new to the channel, remember to hit that subscribe button. And if you could share this video with family and friends or anybody else that you think may enjoy it, it would be much appreciated. Well, like I say, that's going to be it. Thanks for watching today's episode, and we shall see you in the next one. Bye for now.